One thing we're not crazy about is this faucet that came with the house.
All right, so what don't you like about it?
Not crazy about the color, and it's just a little bit beat up.
All right, so this is this darker burnished brass finish, and I noticed some calcium buildup on the outside right here. And actually, the finish on the faucet does not match the finish on the drain. Well, nowadays, it's pretty straightforward to just get a new faucet, go to the home center, pick one out for $100 or less, and then replace it. Usually, it's pretty simple. Oh boy, I think I might have spoke too soon, Ed. The faucet might be simple, but look at this on the drainage side. You actually have two traps under here.
Two traps is a problem?
Two traps is not good, and it's not legal. Here's why. Normally, you want to have a single trap that has water right in this seal right here to keep sewer gas from coming up and making a smell in the bathroom. Now, when you have two traps like this and the way it's piped is also called a full S, watch what happens. Water will come down through the trap. And now, to have a siphon, you have to have the presence of a short leg and then a long leg, which is exactly what you have here. Water comes through, comes up the short leg. Now, the weight of that water pulls, and now it pulls the water out of that trap. Comes down into this trap. Look what you have right here. Another short leg, another long leg. So now it would go here, create another siphon, and now you could end up with two traps with neither one of them having any water in it. And that's not good. And that's not all. Look at this. I also noticed that there's no vent on this. It's unvented. And if it's unvented, it can cause all kinds of issues. Let me prove it by filling this basin with water. All right, so this basin is full. Now, normally when I pull this stopper, this slug of water goes down. And now behind it's looking for air, and the plumbing vent normally breaks that vacuum. Let's see what happens without a vent. It should be getting thirsty for air. Oh. See the little tornado cyclone? That is an unvented sink.
That doesn't sound good. Can we fix this?
Actually, we can. Let's start by getting rid of the old faucet, disconnect it, and get the plumbing out of the way.
Do it, then. Take it right out of there.
All right, so here's the new faucet you picked out.
Well, my girlfriend picked out.
Well, she has very good taste. It's brushed nickel. It's got this nice waterfall spout right here. That'll look great. Now, it can be mounted into a single hole, but you've actually got the three holes in the existing countertop. Just hold that up so I can just go, and that'll look great, okay? And the nice thing is it also has, what you don't have now, a pop-up that matches the finish.
Very nice.
I think this is some of the stuff you can do, though. Let's go.
Okay.
All right, Ed, just grab some of that putty, and let's just make a seal on the bottom of that plate. All right, so that's putty. Now I want to show you the connection you're going to make underneath. We need to tighten this faucet down so you can see this yoke right here. It's going to go onto this long bolt right here, and then you're going to take this nut and tighten it up, tighten it up, tighten it up until you pull this so tight that we squeeze out the putty right here, okay? So you take those underneath.
Okay. It's pretty tight under here.
Yep, that's why I have you doing it, brother.
Sneaky.
I've outgrown it.
All right, so the faucet's connected. Good job. Now it's time to think about the drain line.
Great.
So, remember your old drain right here? Water came down through two traps. Whoop, de-loop, de-loop, de-loop. Always looking for air, and it couldn't get it. So here's what we're going to do to correct it. We're going to cut in a T-Y right here. And here is our drain. It's going to come down through a single trap, the right number of traps for this job. And the water will go this way and down the drain. Well, if I was doing this installation new, this port right here would go to a vent that went through the roof, but that would require me to open up the walls right now, which I don't think you want me to do.
Let's see if we can work around that.
But what I'm going to use instead is this. This is a mechanical vent. This will allow air to come in this way. When the water's going by, air will be able to be drawn in to break the vacuum. But it will never let sewer gas go out this way. Let me show you how it works. So now, when water's coming this way, it's going to pull, so I'm going to pull. Air's going in. If I push, can't go out.
Okay.
All right. So that's going to be a perfect solution for this. All right. Now it's time to glue it all together.
All right.
I've applied plumber's putty to the top of the drain connections and tightened it up. And now I just need to clean and glue our PVC connections. That should do it.
How's it looking, Richard?
We are doing great. I'm just cleaning up, so give it a test.
Okay.
I like that waterfall faucet. That spout's pretty
cool. That's nice.
All right, hot and cold. Make sure it comes out of both sides. Yep. All right, look at the drain here. A little different. Normally, it has an operator back here. This one, you just push the drain down, and it's closed. And now I think we should fill this up and test our mechanical vent. Let's fill the basin and see if we have a cyclone.
I hope not.
All right, so let's try our mechanical drain. Feel that going down. No big gurgle like it used to. That is the way a sink is supposed to drain.
That is great.
Congratulations, you have a new faucet, a new drain, and a vent that works.
Okay, thank you so much for all your help.
It was my pleasure.